The practice of human sacrifice dates back even further.
Death in Kerma, particularly for the elite, seemed to be something of a spectacle. However, these may very well have been retainers who would have served the king in life and thus would serve him in death. Even the idea that these were slaves captured in foreign wars and killed as a sort of triumphal act.
The earliest settlement in Kerma has been dated to 4000 BC. Settlements in Mesopotamia formed into the earliest cities. But recent archaeological finds show that Kerma was developing into a complex society at the same time. By 2500 BC, it's estimated that the city's population had grown to over 10,000, and its power and wealth rivaled that of its northern neighbor, Egypt. Today, little remains of what was once a magnificent planned city built around monumental architecture as grand as that of early Egypt.
The archaeology of the city itself centered around what seems to be a vast structure. This is known as the Defufa. Different scholars have different ideas about what it could be. In terms of mud brick architecture, it certainly seems to be the largest and earliest in Africa.